So Konstantinos Tsagarakis is our next speaker. While you're preparing your slides, Konstantinos, I would like to present you briefly. So you're a professor of economics of environmental science and technology at the Technical University of Crete. Konstantinos is shining the spotlight on a use case on circular economy research and a view on societal impacts and priorities. Konstantinos, the floor is yours.
Thank you for the introduction and the invitation to participate in this very interesting meeting. I would like to mention that I'm very fresh in this affiliation. Some of you may know me being in the Department of Environmental Engineering, Democritus University of Thrace up to last August. And I will share some research findings and some research directions of my team. And some of them are published, some are not, but I will give you some links to follow if you are interested in any of them. So one work already published is at macro level. This has to do with the social and economic determinants of materials recycling and circularity in Europe, an empirical investigation. As you can see on the right of this slide, there is free access for a few weeks. So if you are interested, you can follow this. I will post it later on in the chat to make it easier. But if you want to share my slides, you are free to write me and I can share with the organizers. So what we did in this, we investigated at micro level. We looked at how the recycling rate of municipal waste and how the circular material use rate can be influenced by other indicators. And most of them are from the social sciences. What is important to see is that these are new indicators, and speaking about the circular material use rate is just 10 years data. The previous publication I showed you is only for 8 years. So this means that there is a short span, but there are many European countries that can contribute, and this with an econometric analysis, panel data analysis can give us some insights. In short, the definition of recycling rate of municipal waste is the indicator that measures the share of recycled municipal waste in the total municipal waste generation. And the circularity indicator measures the share of material recovery and feedback to the economy. The full definition can be found in Eurostat. So there are indicators that are reported in the Eurostat from all European countries. And there is data if you want to look at it. And the link is on the bottom of this slide. And I will skip the econometric specification, but I will mention only the variables that we investigated. So, and what we mentioned in this paper is that the indicators at micro level, at survey level, let's say, are those that we took from microeconomic analysis to use to the macro economic analysis. So the GDP per capita is one indicator that may influence the circularity rate. The university education, the level of education is the other variable. The fertility rate, which is an important social variable that is interesting to see in this paper, how we have found other literature that can relate to circular economy, the urbanization level, the environmental taxes, and the R&D expenditures. These are the variables that we looked into to see how they may influence the recycling and the circularity rate. These are two maps to show that the recycling and circularity are not the same level addressed by the European countries. And it doesn't mean that a well-performing country in recycling can be well-performing in circularity also. Here are some descriptive statistics, just to mention that at European level, 8.56% was the mean value, because this bit, the data was up to 2017, but it hasn't changed much during the last 2 years. So more or less, it's 8.56% the circularity rate. With of course, there are countries from 2% up to almost 30%. About 30% is Netherlands, which is a positive outlier. Here is the models that we developed, but I will skip them and I will go to the main findings. We found that the richer economies seem to take more actions towards recycling and circularity. We use recycling as a model to see how it behaves in comparison with circularity. That's why we mentioned them here together, and we have estimated the same models, and we try to find the same exploratory variables. So the GDP, as I mentioned, per capita is a variable that affects circularity. The more wealthy the economy, the better the performance of the country in terms of circularity. Higher fertility rate and higher education level indicate that these countries are more likely to carry out pro-environmental behavior. And as I said, there are many references in the paper that support this. R&D programs are essential for advanced necessary technology of waste and wastewater management, since without scientific research and development, several environmental issues may arise. So R&D programs in affect positively the circularity. Environmental taxes also may act as an incentive for circularity and recycling. And urbanization has a positive impact to circularity and recycling, but with a decreasing trend. This means that there is a turn of point up to which it doesn't have this positive effect. So this one was published. And the other one, which is under review, but I can share with you some findings we have there, is that here we study 18 selected European economies. And the reason behind that is that we used indicators outside Eurostat. And here we wanted to study only the circularity variable and other variables that had to do with entrepreneurship. So here are the variables we studied. The circularity rate was the dependent variable. The GDP per capita was an exploratory variable. The entrepreneurship, the human development index, which is a geometric mean of the normalized indices of achievement and long and healthy life, and the level of knowledge, education, and the level of standard of living. These are socioeconomic development indicators. And you can see here on the last column, the source of these indicators. Also the research and development expenditures of the countries, the gas emissions of the countries, and the foreign direct investment inflows. So here is the model specification. Here are some descriptive statistics per country. I will skip them. Also the empirical analysis, the models, but I will mention the main findings. The main finding shows that at country level, at macro level, the entrepreneurship, innovation, economic growth, and socioeconomic development indicators shows that can be important contribution to circular economy, at least in Europe, because this is a study region. Entrepreneurship positively affects circularity rate. The polluting entrepreneurship, which is proxied with the CO2 emissions, has of course a negative impact on the circularity. The income per capita also in this work shows that has a positive and significant effect to circularity. The human development index also has a positive effect on circularity. The technological innovation also has a positive impact on circularity, but we couldn't locate any financial development effects from the relevant indicator to the circularity. So I will now move to another direction of research we are doing, and this has to do with big data, let's say, because this is how I know that social scientists classify this data, data that we may collect from the internet, data that we may collect from the social media. And as it was mentioned so up to now, It was said that the secular, in surveys, people state their preference and their beliefs. But sometimes from the internet, we take the revealed and not the stated preferences. And this has to do with issues that are posted, for example, in the social media. You know that there is a lot of literature and very recent literature with journal papers on Twitter, on analysis from tweets from Twitter. There's a lot of data from analysis from searches in the internet, from Google Trends, for example. And here we tried to see what data we could take from LinkedIn, also focused in the European region. And this is because LinkedIn is also for people's, but also from companies. And we know that entrepreneurship, as I showed in the previous section of my publication, is an important aspect for circular economy. So we tried to collect data to show how different countries behave in terms of circularity. We realized that there are many, a lot of data free of charge, which is an important issue. And one of LinkedIn is very important for job advertising and business profiling. There is semi-structured data and it's open data that you can collect. We collected the data from 4,048 companies from all 28 European countries and with the term circular economy. Then we filter and we classify it, to make it short. We used a help LinkedIn helper tool, which is an external tool. It's not free, but it's not that expensive. So we collected data from the companies and we processed them. Here I will show just some basic classification. We took the staff count of these companies, the year of foundation and type of industry they report. And we could create graphs like heat maps like this, where we could see in each country what is the staff per 500,000 of population. And you see how these are distributed over Europe. So here you can see the classification we did in seven categories. We see that the countries perform differently in each category. For example, here is a detailed table, but you can see here, for example, in agriculture and food, that Malta, Slovenia, and UK perform better. In construction, manufacture, and mining, it's Czech Republic, it's Estonia, Czech Republic, Italy, Spain, etc. And environment-related companies, Bulgaria, Hungary, Greece, etc. So this is a way. I will skip the rest just to save time, but it's here if you want to share with you. It's important also to see that the profiles of the people per country, the profiles of LinkedIn per 100 people is related, of course, to the companies. The number of companies per 1 million people, you can see that there is a positive relation because there is a different level of people connected per country. But in general terms, they give us a good idea because companies that do with modern, let's say, issues, and one circular economy is by far one of the most new and interesting issues, would be on the LinkedIn and will have an open profile for people to reach them. So the year of foundation is also an issue that we looked in. And as you can see, companies established from the 90s started to deal with this, with circular economy. And this is much increasing after the 2011. You can see the trend. Of course, the last year is not very representative. So we realized that each country shows a different distribution of companies in the designated industry categories. And circular economy can be combined with many business and industry sectors, raising a company's diversity and adapting against the new environmental demands. And also, we did a supplementary analysis just to see what are the other issues these companies are dealing, more specific. And you can see here that the people, companies that are dealing with sustainability, sustainable development, energy, construction, green research, packaging, waste management, etc., supply chain, etc., are issues that these companies are dealing with. So I would like to share you some resources and the publication outlets. One is this special issue that we edited with that was related to one of the conferences we organized. There are 56 papers published in this special issue, and many of them are dealing with social issues. And it's still freely available from this link you can see on the right here. I will also post this link to the chat for those who are interested to follow. I think it's free till the end of the year. And also for those interested in research, there is an open special issue of circular economy as a driver for achieving sustainable production and consumption. And this is now open. It will be by the end of summer. So if you are interested in submitting your work here, it's more than welcome. Also, there is a section on circular economy in the Frontiers in Sustainability Journal. This is a free open access, so it's free to access any paper. And there are several special issues. They are called research topics in this journal, which are, you can submit your work, but also, here is a list of them, but also if you are want to organize a research-oriented research topic, just get in touch with me and we can discuss this and make it online. And also, we are organizing a series of symposiums on circular economy and sustainability. Two of them were meant to be organized in Thrace, in Alexandroupolis, but due to COVID, they went online. But the third one will be physically or in mode, and it will be organized in Chania, in Crete, which is a very nice venue. And we haven't decided the dates yet, but if you follow my profile in LinkedIn, you will see very soon the details of this symposium. So this is my presentation. If there are any questions, please let me know. I hope this was some interesting information for you. It was not exactly in the core of surveys, but all these are also social data. And some of the variables that we are looking for are can be used as exploratory variables in any survey. Many social survey.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Konstantinos. That was really interesting and so many takeaways. I'll pull out a couple of them. I think you've highlighted the importance of using a diverse and rich set of data sets.